What do you do, Libras? Happy Sexy Sunday. Welcome back to our channel. Sprinkled in your chart, you are welcome right here. Welcome back and welcome in, Libras. Happy Soulful Sunday. Are you feeling it in your soul? Somebody is. Hello to all of my new subscribers, my faithful, ever-growing few. And for those of you just breezing on through, what to do? Libras, let's tap right on into these energies and see what may be going on in your world. Now, as per usual, some or all of these messages may or may not resonate with you in this current passage of moments. So please do only take the messages that vibrate with you. If it's not what rings true for you, then most likely it's not what it did. You know what to do, don't you, Libras? Go ahead and just leave it on the counter. Thank you all so much for your likes, your shares, your subscribes, your presence, your energy, your vibe, your comments, your contributions. Thank you all so much, whether you are Libra or not. Your presence is greatly appreciated. So, Libras, let's get into these energies. Angels, what's going on for my Libras? Some wild energies? Oh, look at that. Three in a row. Look at this. What is this? The Seven of Swords. Aquarius. We have the Five of Cups. Scorpio. And we have the Two of Pentacles. Capricorn. What is going on here? I just heard the crew's all here. Everyone seems to be looking in the same direction. Everyone's looking to the left. What's going on here? So we have the Page of Blades. A little bit of air energy. Some more air energy. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. We have the Five of Bones. Leo in the house. Yeah, the crew's all here. And we have the Knight of Blades. on the opposite side of this Five of Bones, this Leo energy. And we have Temperance here and reverse. What is going on? Pretty white dress. Everyone seems to be looking at this Aquarius, especially this Leo and this Capricorn. I don't know what their involvement is, but I feel like this Aquarius is involved with this Leo and this Capricorn in some shape, form, or fashion. Then we've got this air energy on opposite sides of this Leo energy. And he's looking at this Knight of Blades energy. So it could be this Aquarius. Yeah, someone's not getting their needs fulfilled. That's why this Temperance is here in reverse. I feel like this Aquarius is this Knight of Blades energy. And she's even changed the color of her hair. This Aquarius, it says, the devil made me do it. Yeah, someone's up to some tricks. And I feel like this Aquarius is this Knight of Blades energy. Yeah, she's totally dressed different. She went from the pretty white dress, right? From being wrapped in innocence. Yeah, but her face is mostly in the dark. To here, she looks totally different. But I feel like this is the same energy. See, she's made a sacrifice. Her neck's been cut. And it says, the devil made me do it on her shirt. So she's made some type of blood sacrifice to you know who. Well, it says it on her shirt. So she's dibbled and dabbled in some shit. We're gonna find out. Yeah. And so this Leo, see, this Aquarius has a lot of masculines around her looking at her, but I feel like she's bedazzling a lot of people. I'm not sure where you fit in this situation just yet, Libra, but we're going to get there. I'm not sure what's going on with this Page of Blades here in the middle. We're going to ask another deck. So someone's been studying, and it could have been this Aquarius. She's in between these two businessmen. When you look at this Two of Pentacles, this Capricorn energy, he looks very much like a businessman, yes? And then you look at this Five of Bones, or the Five of Wands. This Leo energy, he looks like another businessman. So I feel like someone was making a deal with the lesser of two evils. And I'm not sure what's going on, but it feels like this Aquarius decided to more so work with this Five of Bones. This Leo versus this Capricorn. Then you've got this Two of Cups here. This Cancer energy. Like who are all these men that this Aquarius is working with? Again, I'm getting the feeling of choosing between the lesser of two evils. And if you're looking at this Two of Pentacles, this Capricorn has a big pentagram behind their head. So it's like this person is
This person may be a high priest. This person may be a high level, we'll just say, we'll call it, for lack of a better term, a leader in a secret society. So this is a high level person in some sort of secret society or high level group. This is a businessman. And if you look at his pose, now he has what's called a Napoleonic pose. And that is when a gentleman sticks his hand inside his jacket. It's normally between the second and third button. Sometimes it's between the first and second, but you see he's got three buttons. So he's got it between the first and the second. So he's definitely of a higher echelon. Tyrant. So this person is tyrannical. So this Aquarius stopped dealing with this tyrannical Capricorn. But it's like she started studying, and she may have started studying the occult because you have symbols or glyphs, ancient symbols or glyphs behind this young Page of Blades. And you see here she has the same color hair, right? I feel like this is also her energy, this Page of Blades. So she may have cut her hair and dyed her hair, this Aquarius. See here, her hair is dark. Here in this Page of Blades energy, it's still dark, but it's shorter. Because her hair is shorter, she's having to rethink things, so she's starting over. But what she's starting over is in learning something new, and what she's learning seems to be dark occult knowledge. So wherein she didn't want to deal with this high-level authority figure, this Capricorn energy over here, who she decided to work with is this Five of Bones, this Leo energy. So it's looking, and it appears, it feels like this Capricorn felt like this Leo energy had more strength, like this person had more backing. And they're giving me old money. So this person has connections. They have long status. So this person has been a high-level authority figure for a long time. They just said government official, so this could be a government official. But you see, so this person may have become this Aquarius's handler, is what I just heard. You see, he's got the glyphs and the ancient writings on the wall behind him. Look at his damn smile. Doesn't he look like a politician? He looks like a fucking liar, doesn't he? A scumbag, a sleazebag. A fugazi. He's a whole fake. But he's got power. So this Aquarius decided to... I just heard become an underling. So this Aquarius is now the underling of this Leo energy. What in the actual... Why is this Temperance here in reverse? It says that's gonna leave a mark from Tommy Boy. 1995 could be significant. So the 14th could also be significant. And we have Earth energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. So this is this Capricorn energy. So she did not want to work with this Capricorn because she felt like this Capricorn was going to harm her or endanger her. That's going to leave a mark. What's up with this Capricorn? Who is this tyrant? It says, it's like someone hit a pinata full of white people who suck at golf. The Big Short. And then we have You're Gonna Die, Clown, from Happy Gilmore. Interesting that this is two movies about golf, Happy Gilmore and The Big Short. Someone's name could be Martin. So we have water energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, and a little bit of earth, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. So this businessman might like to do business on the golf greens. Someone's last name is Green, G-R-E-E-N-E. What's going on with this deal? Says, I'm a genuine Holy Ghost Jesus filled preaching machine this morning from the apostle. Drama. Very interesting that this should pop up, because I do not feel like this person is anything of the sort as of which this card suggests. This person is the complete opposite. See, there's an inversion here. So again, this Leo showed this Aquarius some form or level of strength, of power, of status, of rank to attract this Aquarius to him. But he played upon her innocence, and he's taken her in under, it's like, you know, when you join a cult, you think it's one thing and then you get in there and they brainwash you into something totally different. And I feel like this is a lot of what this energy is. Libra, I don't know what this has to do with you yet, but we're going to keep on going. I want to know what's up with this Knight of Blades. It says, no one ever made a difference by being like everyone else. So this Aquarius, we have the Greatest Showman. So she wanted to join the club. So she wanted status. She wanted ranking. She wanted some type of power. And she was led into this group versus this group, the lesser of two evils, because she thought or was shown, again, that this may have been some type of religious group, or they just showed her something innocent, is what I'm really getting. It doesn't necessarily have to be a religious group in nature, but whoever this Leo is, this high-ranking person who seems to have more ranking and status than whoever this Capricorn energy is, she went and took the bait and went and joined this group with this person, this gentleman, this energy. But he has her learning dark occult things, and she's even changed up again. She's dyed and cut her hair. She's dressing differently. Look at how she used to dress, like a country girl. Alabama could be significant. To now, look how she's dressing. Total switch up. Temperance is upside down. This is not a good move for her. This is going to leave a mark. See, again, the lesser of two evils. It's still evil. So it's still going to leave a mark whether you dealt with this one or you dealt with that one. This Aquarius that pops up every now and again, Libra. Some Aquarius from your past that's just not too happy about the fact that you weren't too keen on them. The feelings were not equal. Angels, what else? It says, have faith in your dreams. Waxing crescent moon. So she was in a low space. She felt down. She wasn't having any faith in her dreams. We have nothing is yet set in stone. So it's like this Capricorn sent this Cancer after this Aquarius because nothing is yet set in stone. So while she thinks she got away from this Capricorn, it's like he sent his henchmen. So you know how there's levels in the mafia, right? There's like the Don, and then there's like the father, and then you have like little henchmen under them. Well, like this Capricorn is kind of like a Don, and then he's got henchmen under him, and this Cancer is one of his henchmen that he went to go send to look for this Aquarius because nothing is yet set in stone. So while she thinks it's over, it's not over. So there's people looking for her. So this Capricorn has someone looking for her. It says you're very close to achieving your goal. Wow. So this Capricorn is very close to finding out where this Aquarius is. So it's like things are looking up for him. Again, I'm getting this pentagram. So he may be utilizing some form of magic to send his flying monkeys. Look at the wings behind this Cancer. So everybody wants to play with magic. Is it still Halloween? I just said Samhain, so Samhain could be significant. So this Capricorn needed this Aquarius for something. Libra, I don't know if this is you. It could be. I'm just not sure where you fit in this story. I'll be real honest. This Capricorn feels like things are looking up, like they're close to this Cancer, finding out where this Aquarius, or it could be you, Libra, where you are. So this Capricorn is sending flying monkeys to this Aquarius. Libra, I still in my gut. That tells me that's not you though. I take it how it resonates. And so it says take time to breathe out. Yeah, again. So I feel like this Aquarius. This Aquarius has been learning, they've been studying, they took a break to learn some new things. They've been stirring up some things as well. Stirring up the knowledge that is being taught to them by whoever this Leo is. You see this? It's time to take action, yeah. So this Leo has taken action. This Leo has taken action to take this Aquarius under their wing. This person is very bullheaded. Yes, I know you see the ram, but... I just heard soft tyrant. So this person, again, draws people in with his cool nature. He appears to be a cool, even-headed person. Even-keeled is what I just heard. But that's how he draws people in. It's always in the eyes, right? Look at his eyes. This person may have a twitch in their left eye. So this Aquarius wears her heart upon her sleeve. And that's why she was so drawn in by this Leo, because they seem to be such an even-keeled, a very peaceful person. They presented themselves to be maybe even God-fearing. Because remember what this card says. It says, I'm a genuine Holy Ghost, Jesus-filled preaching machine this morning. So he caught this Aquarius at a low point in her life, because there's drama here on this card. So he caught this Aquarius in her emotions. He appeared to her to be, again, someone who may be God-fearing. That's how he drew her in, how he sucked her in. But now he's got her learning some really dark shit. Look, it says a time for healing. She needs some really deep healing, because this is not the way to go. She's going to outcast herself. And it says, no one ever made a difference by being like everyone else. See, by joining this club and really trying to be like everyone else, she's really outcasting herself. And she's going to end up with a mark. I just heard a mark on her soul. It says, a win-win outcome is forecast. Full moon in Libra. So, Libra, is this you, this Temperance upside down? The ancestors are knocking. So this is this Aquarius that keeps rolling back through every now and again. Who is this Aquarian female? And it's a female, Libras. And she keep getting caught up with the wrong people, and she's still trying to do shit to you to have you flipped upside down. But you see what the card says under this upside down Temperance. Libra, it's going to go your way. A win-win outcast is forecasted for you. Full moon in Libra. So things are coming to light about this Aquarius that is still trying to put the dibble dabble on you, because I don't know, Libra, you don't like her. This could be same sex energy. This could be a friend. This could be a family member. I don't know who she is to you. You know. Let's see what else. Because the ancestors very much want you to chime in. So for some strange out reason, this Aquarius doesn't like the fact that you have faith in your dreams. That you seek out what it is you want to manifest in your personal reality. Like, you work on your spiritual garden. You don't just expect things to come to you. You actually put in the work, the effort, and you make shit grow. You sprinkle the miracle grow, and you make shit grow. And she's wearing her heart on her sleeve. And Libra, you wronged this female, this chick, in some shape, form, or fashion. And she's still wearing her heart on her sleeve, and she's got a bone to pick with you. I mean, she's got a real vendetta out for you. Out here making blood sacrifices, what, to get back at you? This is very dangerous behavior. I don't know if people really recognize and realize the things that they do. It doesn't just affect you in the here and the right now and the current passage of moments. The shit that you do can have an effect for eons. And I just can't get over the fact that this card says that's gonna leave a mark. As I said before, it's going to leave a mark upon her soul. for trying to see you upside down, Libra. So this is the tea that you needed to hear, that this Aquarius is still out here with the dibble dabble, syncing and linking up with groups, thinking and hoping that that's going to give her some type of status, some type of ranking wherein she will be at such a height as to be able to come back and get at you. Oh, it's a whole mouthful. This is, oh my goodness. Alrighty, here we go. Divine Sun Child. This is who she tried to come against, you. The Dark Mysteries. Yeah, this is what she was playing with. We have Stay True and Be in Your Power. Serpent of Fire. We have Enter the Chamber of Healing. Goodness gracious, these cards fly. 1 second. And right on the floor, Scales of Balance. Is that balance on top of balance? Because it kind of looks like it. Libra, this is what's forecasted for you. Your scales aren't going to be off balance by this situation, this energy, or this entity at all. No, Libra, because your shit will not be out of whack. It very much will stay intact and in balance. This is what's destined for you. No matter what these other people try to do. They keep trying to put marks on you and they end up with marks on themselves. Divine Sun Child, Blessings of the Sun Falcon. A little bit of Horus energy here. So much protection around you, Libra. Your ancestors watch over you day and night. Because you are a child of the light. So people always are after the mysteries that you know. People always want to know, well, what does Libra know? And people are willing to tap into other mysteries in order to get into the mystery of you. And, well, fortunately, that's not how that works. But unfortunately for them, they get to find out. Don't they, Libra? It says, enter the chamber of the dark goddess. So this is what this Aquarius did. She linked up with this other group, the lesser of two evils, linked up with this Leo instead of this Aquarius, and decided to learn some dark mysteries in order to somehow combat you. We have Stay True and Be in Your Power. It says, Osiris and Isis, Lord and Lady of Divine Authority. What did I tell you? This Capricorn is an authority figure. But Libra, who has authority and power in your life, is way more powerful than this mortal. This Capricorn. That was going to help this Aquarius do what? I don't know. We know what she did over here with this Leo, though. It says Serpent of Fire. Priestess of the Serpent Sisterhood. So she went and got herself involved with some snakes. Some Slytherins. Harry Potter could be significant. There we go with the magic. I don't know if this Aquarius wears glasses. Well, when you play with snakes, you might get bit and infected with their poison. And this lady has indeed been poisoned. See, she took the time to take a breath out and breathe in the evil breathed in darkness. This is what she chose to involve herself in. It says, enter the chamber of healing. See, again, this is what this Leo offered her.
Yeah, come join our group. We can help you. We can heal you. Told her he was a Jesus preaching machine.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Brought her right into the darkness. It says, healing in the divine chamber of the Lady Isis. Yeah, he's a good fake. He made it look all nice, dressed it up real good. She joined a cult, is what, pardon me, what she did. It looked real inviting, real enticing, was real colorful, it was real vibrant, but it turned real dark. She made a blood sacrifice to be in this group, to be connected to this Leo, to be able to learn this knowledge again. She became his underling. He is her handler. So we have Cartouche. It says, divine names of power. So again, she thought she could make a name for herself. She thought that she would gain status, that she would gain some type of ranking. What if she came after you? What if she promised them you? So this Aquarius promised this group you, Libra, because you're a divine sun child. Again, the knowledge you have. So you stopped talking to this Aquarius. I don't know what you talked about with this Aquarius, but this Aquarius knows that you contain ancient knowledge. So because you cut off contact with this Aquarius, and it doesn't have to be an Aquarius, okay? It's just an energy. But you cut off contact with this person, so she linked up with this group. The lesser of two evils, she went over here instead of going over there and learned some dark shit so that she could come back and combat you. Because you hold secret ancient knowledge that what you didn't want to share with her and that what you weren't attracted to her, be you a female or male, Libra. High Vibe Tribe definitely talking to you, but look, she wanted her name to be on the wall. She wanted to have a legacy. And the song just said, love gone down the drain. So this was love gone down the drain. Again, these were feelings not returned. She just keeps returning back to you. The devil made her do it. Libra, things are going to be balanced out for you. Someone's name could be Jordan. Or someone wears Jordans. And things are going to be balanced out for you, Libra, because it's your time. It's your time, Libra. And nothing that anyone does, no matter who they link up with, this is not going to balance out for them because the scales will always sway in your favor because you are a divine sun child. Because you choose to do right. It's a choice we all have to make. It's not an easy one. Well, it could be, and it can't be, it would be, it should be, is it? Let's see what else is going on with you, Libra. So this Aquarius, I feel like now they don't know anything different. Now all they know is the dark. The dark that they walked into. Where you are is where it's at. Yeah, this person, it's like they just can't stop coming after you because where you are, Libra, is where it's at. Like, this person is deeply hurt by you. Like, my chest feels tight. And what else? I just heard an immortal inflicted a mortal wound. So take that how that resonates. Thank you for my Libras, please. So we have the reward. Yeah, this Capricorn. Well, this Capricorn. Interesting. So this Capricorn knows you're the reward. This Aquarius knows you're the reward. And it looks like this Aquarius promised you to this Leo, this head of this occult group, this cult. Because you're the reward. Libra, you've been dancing today? I know I've been dancing today. You've been feeling it in your soul? Do you feel like something's coming, Libra? Do you feel like a reward is coming? Libra, you're coming. That's the thing. It's you who is coming. I said, celebrate your magnificence. Yeah, this Aquarius would like to. They would like to get swept up with you. I don't know what is going on here, but yeah, this Aquarius really has a thing for you. Again, I don't know who this chick is. It's a female. And this, what else? Someone's name could be Destiny. Or Destiny's Child. Time for a quantum leap. Yeah, I told you. This Capricorn sent this Cancer after this Aquarius. They've been hop skipping around. This could be the Aquarius from the other reading that relocated. Yeah, this Aquarius is after your energy. Oh, when are they not, Libra? When are they not? Can some of these people take a break? Anybody go on holiday? No? You going on holiday? It says, prepare for makeover. Yeah, well. Because this Capricorn is really trying to get this Aquarius back. They want them to have a makeover, like a switchover. You know, like when you switch phone companies, like some phone companies, they'll be like, yeah, if you switch over, we'll switch you over for free. Like, we'll cancel with your other company and you can just switch over. It's like, yeah, this Capricorn has sent this Cancer after this Aquarius to, yeah, go ahead, track her down, get her to go ahead and make that switch, come back to our side. I don't know what's going on over here. This is so, no words. In the Castle of Dreams, say yes to your higher calling. It says, become altered by the color of your dreams. So this Capricorn wants to, like, build or paint pictures. It's like they want to paint castles in the sky for this Aquarius to tempt them to come back. Why is everyone trying to entice this Aquarius to their side? I don't know what's going on with her. Let's ask angels. Why is everyone after this Aquarius? What's going on with her? It says, don't push it or I'll give you a war you won't believe. Let it go, let it go. First blood. What did I say? She made a blood sacrifice, right? Okay. It says, it doesn't matter if you win or lose. It's what you do with your dancing shoes. As I was just talking about dancing just a moment ago, So we've got air energy here, right on top of this Aquarius, yes? Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. And we also have water energy. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio from Greece. So we have first blood in Greece. So this Aquarius may have been born between 78 and 82. So they're at war for her soul. Because they turned an innocent.
Is this what this is?
So they want her because she was an innocent and she turned. It says it doesn't matter if you win or lose, is what you do with your dancing shoes. So it's like she couldn't win on her own against you somehow to get you, to combat you, to do something to you. I don't know. But she couldn't do it on her own. So she figured instead of losing, she would sync up or link up with someone else who could help her, who could assist her, and somehow Libra combating you, fighting you, coming against you, getting with you. I don't know what she wanted to do. So she was on the skids. We have Greece here. So it's like she was on Skid Row. She was down low. And she needed some help, some assistance. And somehow or another, she came into contact with two of these businessmen. Both of them. It appears in two different high-level groups. He's more of a businessman who just kind of has dark knowledge and ties. This is more a cult leader who passes himself off to, again, maybe be a Jesus preaching person. He is not. So she was an innocent and she made a blood sacrifice when she joined up with this Leo energy in his group. And now because she's in this darker energy, there's a fight. She's already working for this Leo, but this Capricorn, I don't know if he's aware that she has made this blood sacrifice, because we have first blood here. And it says, don't push it or I'll give you a war you won't believe. Remember, she left this Capricorn. It says, let it go, let it go. So I don't know if she made the blood sacrifice first with this Capricorn, and then she left him and moved into what appeared to be a safer space with this Leo working with him. But she's been duped not once but twice, and well, now she's on the other side. She's joined the other side. Look, it says say yes to your higher calling. It says be a human exclamation mark. She has been trying to make her mark. She's been trying to leave a legacy. She wants to be known. She wants to have status, to have ranking, to have power. So this is what this Leo promised her. He promised her power. Learn what I'm going to teach you and you will attain this power. You can have whatever you want. You can have whomever you want. So again, this Aquarius thought that she would learn this dibble-dabble and she could come back and put the dibble-dabble on you, Libra, to make you turn her way. It's not how it goes. Yeah, thank you, angels. It was a bit murky at first, but we were going to suss it out. We have, there's no place like home. Yeah. Yeah, because this Aquarius, again, has promised you to like this group, to this leader. It says, eyes on the prize. I can't make this shit up. Let me show you. Right under this Leo energy. There's no place like home. Nestle into the sweetness. This Leo wants this Aquarius to bring you home, Libra, to bring you back into their cavern. Oh, I just heard coven. So this Leo may want this Aquarius to bring you back into their coven. Again, understand, she's made a blood sacrifice. So she's made some promises. She's also been promised some things. But boy, old girl. Girl, oh boy, if she doesn't keep up her end. Because what is she looking at, Libra? What is this
Knight of Blaze, this Aquarius, Aquarian energy looking at, she's looking at you because you are a queen, you are a king. Among queens, among kings. She most definitely has her eyes on the prize, and that is you. It says, trust the guidance of your North Star. She feels like she keeps being led back to you.
So she's tried to find out information on your chart as well, Libra, this Aquarius. She wants you so bad. Goodness gracious. She's more than feisty. I just... Oh, please, calm down. This one here, Libra. We have X marks the spot. It says, see the love in disguise. Libra, you are it. You are the one. You, Libra, you. Ma'am, sir, lady, man. High vibe tribe. Still talking to you. X marks the spot. You're it, Libra. You're the it girl. You're the it boy. You're the it factor. And boy, there are so many people who would like to add you to their equation. But Libra, that's not what's in the scales, right? That's not what's in the scales. They said get a few more cards, so we're going to check on these energy spots, and then we'll get some other energies from your chart, from their chart, Libra, and then we'll get you all out of here. Thank you all so very much for stopping by, for spending time, for sharing this passage of moments with your girl. I appreciate you. I love you. Yeah, she got it so bad for you, Libra. So bad. Well, now you know. And knowing is half the battle. G.I. Joe, American Heroes. G.I. Joe is there. I don't know why. Listen. I just go with the flow. If it comes up, if it sounds weird, if it seems weird, that's just who I am. Shit, maybe I'm a little weird. I like it. I love it. It's me. Angels, for my Libras, what are these mental cases thinking in their mental spaces? What are they thinking, Angels? What's this Aquarius thinking? Ooh. I just heard a litany of lies. Wow. All right. Just right on down the line there, huh? Okay. One more, please, there, Angels. And two to go. Here we go. It says, when you realize the hash slinging slasher is really just an unemployed person. Did we not see this card just what? Yesterday, Libra, just yesterday, whatever timeline we were in then. Remember? Remember, Libra? You keep catching these slashers, Libra. You keep catching these slashers. They act real nice. They have on a real nice costume, right? We still see that mask for what it is. You keep catching the hillside strangler. Or the hash-slinging slasher. All these people who seek to cut you up, cut you down, and cut into you. So they just want a piece, Libra. They just want a piece of you. It's forbidden. It says, when your magical pet seahorse becomes addicted to Krabby Patties. So, this Capricorn. I sent this flying monkey. And the flying monkey, Cancer, by the way, happens to be falling for the Aquarius. What kind of... Boy, talk about a shit show. When your magical pet seahorse becomes addicted to Krabby Patties. Because who was Krabby Patty? Well, the Aquarius is Krabby Patty in this situation. Because she wasn't happy with the Capricorn or whatever the fuck was going on with his group. So she left.
And who is the seahorse? The magical seahorse? Well, the magical seahorse with their wings here. Mr. Henchman, who likes to fly around chasing down people because he's a tracker. This is what he does. See, when people don't pay up, when people don't do what the fuck they're supposed to do, well, the tracker gets sent after them, and well, he always finds his man or woman. Well, this tracker cancer man, well, he's fallen for this Aquarius. Miss Krabby Patties, who wasn't happy with this Capricorn. It says, when the Flying Dutchman traps you in Davy Jones' old sock locker. When the Flying Dutchman traps you in Davy Jones' old sock locker. So, because she used to be an innocent who switched sides, she sacrificed. She made a blood sacrifice to the other side. See, she has a certain, we'll say, spiritual value. And so this is why these two groups are kind of fighting for her. But she told this Capricorn, look, don't fight for me. I'm out of here. It'll be a war if you fight for me. Well, it looks like she went to someone who may just have a little bit more power, a little bit more status, a little bit more ranking than this Capricorn does. So he's in a bit of a stinker. He's trapped in Davy Jones' locker, so he feels a bit trapped. Because I don't know if he promised who's over him. Could be the father. You know, the father of the clan, the group, the mafia. I don't know. But what I'm saying here, Libra, is there were a lot of promises made and a lot of promises not kept. And, well, somebody's head has to be on the counter for it. Now we've got this Aquarius who's on the run, who may be hiding amongst this group who she's really not safe with. Because, see, they have a reason for utilizing her just as much as this Capricorn. It says, when you enter your pet's dream and find out that not only can he talk, he's also British. So again, this Aquarius has been doing things in the dark. Trying to get into your dreams, interrupt your dream state. Who did they run into? Some of your spirit animals. Oh, they were talking. They were talking to this Aquarius. And it's funny that they said, when you enter your pet's dream to find out that not only can he talk, he's also British. But see, the thing is they didn't enter their pet's dream. Again, they entered the dream state trying to get into your dream state. They came across your spirit animals. And your spirit animals were talking to them. The fact that they said he's also British, meaning that the animals were talking to him in a British accent, means that your spirit animals were coming at this Aquarius real proper-like. They were speaking in proper English. They were laying it down real close. And what'd they say? Real close and encounter. It was a real close encounter. So, the song said, talking to me too much. So, yeah, your spirit animals were talking to this person a lot. And, again, real proper-like. So, you know how sometimes when you're at work, you speak in your proper voice, you know, when you're around your friends and your family, you know, you just kind of, you know, you let the language go a little bit. So, your spirit animals, as if animals could talk, but listen, you're, and that's why it's extra funny here. Your spirit animals were talking to this person real proper. I can't get over it. I'm cracking up on the inside. Anywho, back to you, Booze. It says, when you give the coworker you don't like an exploding pie. Listen. So again, this person of high status, high ranking. This could be an occult leader or a cult leader.
when you give your coworker you don't like an exploding pie. So again, he's offered this Aquarius, what seems like a real good slice of the pie. Yeah, sure, honey, you're gonna have this. You're gonna have this power. You're gonna have these contacts. You're gonna have this money. Yeah, you're gonna have long money. You're gonna have it the long way. Praise God, praise Jesus. Oh, okay. Is that what you said, Leo? And she fell for it, hook, line, and sinker. You didn't think it was funny, the shit that you were learning, the shit that he was teaching you, the shit that you were studying? You didn't think it was a little bit funny? Mm-mm. No, see, because he's looking at you. See, he's looking past her. See, she brought you up to both of these groups. Libra, oh my goodness, who the fuck is this Aquarius chick? But I'm telling you, this Leo is looking past this Aquarius now at you because she promised you to this group, to this leader, to this Leo. He don't even like her. Yeah, she's, you know, a little bit because she was an innocent who switched. But she doesn't have the power. She doesn't have the knowledge that he's looking for. But since she brought up your name, oh, well, now who is he interested in? You. Who is he looking at? You. Because he's looking way far past her. Again, now this Cancer over here, he really likes this Aquarius. He's fallen in love with her, trying to track her ass down. It's very close to happening. Or so he may have reported back to this Capricorn. It says, when Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy let you house sit for them while they're on vacation. Didn't I tell you she has skipped town? So she went and stayed. She found a place to stay again. She cut ties. She left this group. She may have relocated to another town. So she may be staying with someone, just house sitting. So she may not necessarily have her own place, her own setup, wherever she moved to. When she moved away from this Capricorn in this group to wherever this Leo in this group is. So does she try and get closer to you, Libra? Did she try and... Is she house sitting for someone in your city? You heard this? I can't leave her for nobody. So this Aquarius is, this Aquarius may be in your city. Cause I'm hearing, I'm in your city. Y'all know that song. I'm not going to sing it. But anyways, it says when you're dying for not having water at your friend's house, but you're too anxious to tell them. when you're dying from not having water at your friend's house, but you're too anxious to tell them. So I feel like this is her energy, though. She's at her friend's house again, so she may be staying, okay, Airbnb is what I just heard. So she may be at an Airbnb in your city. Because she's thirsty. Or she may be staying at a friend's house in your city. Mm-hmm, and she's too anxious to tell you that she wants you. So she's going to try and put the dibble dabble on you. So she got closer to you. So again, she may have relocated or traveled or vacationed to your city. She may be staying in an Airbnb or at a friend's house. I don't know if she was sent by this group or through this group. But it's to get closer to you. It's like she had to travel to your city to get literally closer to you in physicality. Because she thinks that the dibble-dabble is going to work if she's closer in vicinity to you. Thank you, angels. It says, when you have to go back to the Milkshake Academy after your milkshake license expires, she's going to have to go back to school. See, all of this is going to reverse on her. See, she's lost her license. See, she has no ability. She has no power. So you remember what I said? She used to be an innocent, but she made a blood sacrifice to the other side. She's no longer innocent. She chose. And so anything that she thinks she's going to sprinkle or dibble-dabble on you is going to go back to her. It's going to be returned. She has lost her license in the realm of dibble-dabble. Okay? It's just not going to work out the way she thinks it is. Ah, when will these people learn? Let's get some other energies. These will be signs in your chart or theirs, Libra. Initials, first, middle, or last, yours or theirs. Angels for my Libras. Signs and energies connected to this reading, please. So this person's been waiting for you. This worries. There's a lot. I'll need it all, Libra. So they may have given this Aquarius some money. She may have been promised money, or she just has money, I guess, dealing with this group. Again, remember what I said? She was down and out. And so it's like they kind of breaded her out, or they may be funding her, is what I heard. So, I don't know whether you swing that way, Libra, but this Aquarius definitely wants you to. Goodness gracious. All right, Libra, almost there. One more. Okay, here we go. So we have Wednesday, Tuesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday night. Could be significant. We have Aries Sun, Aquarius Sun, Scorpio Sun, Libra Sun, Pisces Sun, Cancer Sun, Sagittarius Sun, Capricorn Sun, Taurus Sun, Capricorn Moon, Aries Moon, Pisces Moon, Scorpio Moon, Taurus Moon, Cancer Moon, Virgo Moon, Sagittarius Moon, Gemini Moon, Cancer North Node, Virgo North Node, Sagittarius North Node, Pisces North Node, Capricorn North Node, Libra North Node, Aquarius North Node, Taurus North Node, Gemini North Node, Pisces Rising, Capricorn Rising, Sagittarius Rising, Taurus Rising, Gemini Rising, Leo Rising, Cancer Rising, and Leo Rising.
And as far as initials or letters, first, middle, or last. What are you giving me, angels? So, we have the letters or initials. Again, first, middle, or last. Yours or theirs. S is in Sam. H, Y, T. M is in Mary. O, L is in Larry. E is in Edward. K, C is in Charles. P is in Paul. J, X, W, V is in Victor. G as in go. D is in David. N is in Nancy. So the words I got, Libra, were shit. So someone's in some shit. Maybe this Aquarius. We also have the word mole. So again, this person may have become a mole. This Aquarius. She certainly has a handler. We have KC, Kansas City could be significant. Someone's nickname could be Chief. We have PJ. And we have GDN, and they told me good night. So I don't know if it's good night to this situation. It's a cap put on that. And then we have VWX. I don't know what that is. So this mole could have something to do with a Taurus, a Scorpio, an Aries, or a Capricorn. This shit could have to do with a Libra, a Gemini, a Scorpio, or an Aquarius. PJ could be an Aquarius. Hold on 1 second. Oh, Virgo. Pardon me. So the shit could have something to do with a Libra. I'm sorry, an Aries. My bad, y'all. An Aries, a Gemini, a Scorpio. Or a Virgo. And PJ might be a Virgo or an Aquarius. You may be saying goodnight to a Pisces, a Libra, or a Scorpio. Kansas City or KC may have something to do with a Leo or an Aries. Libras, I love you. Way far past the moon and back. My love knows no bounds, for if it were not for you, I would just be talking to myself. So thank you again for being here, for spending this passage of moments with your girl. Please do always continue to utilize your own intuition and discernment to make the very best decisions for your highest good. I know that you will. I'm rooting for you, Libras. I'm cheering for you. I'm praying for you. United we stand, together we rise. Any and all pertinent information to this reading can and will be listed right down below, Libras. Holla at your girl. Peace.